had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw.
So, did you get my voicemail?
Yes. All of this happened in the last 2 hours.
Yeah, the doll is in that house. I saw it in his jacket.
Why didn't you tell me any of this?
I thought I would handle it myself.
And your way of handling it was breaking and entering?
Just entering. I had the key.
It's still against the law, Jeff.
Like a light bulb.
Oh my gosh, this is so terrible.
That's why I didn't do it, Columbo.
Well, good.
Like Pinocchio.
Pinocchio.
Okay, what are we going to do, though, Pam? We need that doll.
I know what we do, okay? Just let me think. Like Monopoly, that's too late.
Sounds like garbage.
Herman, no, none of that.
Well, it does. You stink.
Here's what we're going to do. We will wait until they come back from vacation, and then I will go over there. I will tell the mom everything, and we'll get the doll back. Get it together.
Are you sure we should wait?
Yes, Jeff. I don't want my husband spending Christmas in jail.
Yippee!
Can I just... go home and wait until this blows over.
This is not blowing over. This is a Category 5. I mean, do you know how many people hate you because of this book?
A lot.
It's showtime.
I thought you were my friend.
Well, right now, I'm your agent. So go out there and charm everybody's pants off. And try not to look so tall. It's intimidating.
I suppose it's possible you might not have read a Sophie Brown novel, but trust me, you know somebody who has. And boy, do I have some questions for her. Oh. Join us in welcoming back my good friend and best-selling author, Sophie Brown. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Thank you for having me. I'm surprised I made it in alive. I barely did. All of you viewers, if you wonder what we're talking about, I'd say that Sophie Brown has a whole lot of unhappy fans out there.
Oh, I think you might mean former fans.
Well, I guess we're all wondering about the ending of your latest book.
I know that the character of Winston charmed many of the readers.
Then why in the world would you kill him? Your readers, they loved Winston.
Maybe they just didn't know him like I did. We don't always get the happy ending.
You know, I normally don't do this, but I have got to agree with the fans out there. He didn't deserve to fall down the stairs.
So you're on their side.
Well, you murdered a man that I was in love with. I mean, what gives you the right to take him away?
I'm the author.
I know, but perhaps you're having a hard time separating your real life from the fiction in your books.
What?
Well, you had a rough year, your husband left you, you had a very messy divorce.
Okay, but Winston is a fictional character.
Was he?
Yes, and you should be happy that it was a quick death. Yeah, because I could have extended it for 10 pages. I could have dragged him behind a car. I could have poisoned him with mercury. I could have chopped him into little teeny pieces and fed him to the sharks.
We'll be right back.
Simon, Sam, you guys got one more present to open.
The same thing to me.
The new Emmett book?
It's the first draft, but I want to know what you guys think before I send it to my publisher.
Emmett at the Christmas Hotel. Is it happy at the end like I said?
You gotta read it.
And Peter and Nick and Emmett moved to New Hampshire.
Hey, you guys want to play? Psych! Boom! I can do this all day.
As I sat there and watched Timmy Keene blast away an inch from the screen, to his evil heart's content, one thing became clear. I needed to get my own Nintendo. Fast.
possessive.
For weeks, I've been plotting how to get my parents to say yes to a Nintendo for Christmas.
Scout, stout.
Tonight was the night I'd finally put my plan into action.
Atticus.
Mom.
Spelled.
Hey, Mom. I'm so sorry, Mom, but I got some ketchup on my sweatshirt.
Oh, gosh. All right, let's get that out before it sets in. You know, we bought that sweatshirt two sizes too big. It's gotta last you another year. It's gonna come out. Wow. Jesus.
My mom was always multitasking, thrived on the chaos. Two things at once, she was golden. But if you gave her a third task to juggle, things got dicey and you could get her to agree to stuff she wouldn't normally agree to.
Hey, so, Mom, I was thinking for Christmas.
Oh, a kid who thinks. How refreshing. Maybe you could teach my students that.
Sure. But, just to make Christmas shopping a little easier for me this year, how about getting me a Nintendo?
Sure. That sounds great.
Mom gauntlet passed.
God bless it!
Is everything all right in there?
Has anyone seen my skill saw?
I think it's in the shower.
And a boy called Christmas disappeared back into the sky.
I don't get it.
Maybe next year.
Come on, it's simple. Use the apple.
Wait, I can figure it out. I've got it.
Can we have another story again soon?
Well, anytime you need one.
How about tomorrow?
No.
Hey. What are you guys doing up? It's way
past
your bedtime.
I think maybe next year we can let Father Christmas do his thing.
Okay, well, how about...
Dad.
I didn't...
It's always the way. The darkest night will end. The sun will rise, and Christmas mornings will come again, when anything and everything can happen.
Mummy would have loved this. She's never gonna come back, is she?
No. But you are the best memory of her now.
Christmas properly began.
Oh, well, it must be. You see, I never lie.